everyone, great to be here with you today. You know, when you're working out, you're wanting to build up your muscles. Now, not that I'm one to speak here. One of the things they tell you to do is take some supplements, protein powder, this, that. It adds to your ability to work out. You stay hydrated. You have the right amount of protein. You're in better shape because of it. We're in a time right now, spiritually, where we want to take that and think about that in a spiritual way. You have a normal walk with the Lord that so many of us have, and you have a faith walk, and it's growing, and you're doing great things. But right now, in the middle of a pandemic, you probably need to add some supplements out of the Bible to hone your senses, to get your maximum abilities at work right now. I'm going to give you this week one specific scripture and some things to hone your abilities spiritually to each day make sure in the middle of a pandemic that things are working for you and how your faith can give you those additional opportunities of insight and strength. So I want to look at what's called in Ephesians chapter 6, the full armor of God. And the first thing you want to do as you look at this list is just understand it's a list of several things, but there's one thing in here I want to see in the full armor of God. So you look at what's going on in the world and you say, how do we not live in fear? Because I think if you want to get outside and you want to go to the grocery store and you want to obey the rules in what you're doing, but you want to listen to God in what you're doing, you need that supplement from the Lord to sharpen your, so to speak, your strength as a person and how you grow. So how do you do that? There's one part of the full armor of God. Full armor of God is totally protective, so it helps you and protects you, which you need right now, right? You need protection in the Lord. You need protection even to do your daily routine or what you do. How you don't live in fear, though, and do that things, let's look at this thing that God says. You put on the full armor of God, and particularly this thing called the sandals or the preparation of your footwear of the gospel of peace. So how do you have peace in the face of fear to do things? Literally, some people are afraid to go outside, literally afraid to go to the grocery store. And that fear can grow on you. You can isolate yourself. And that's probably not what you want to do. The key is that with the gospel of peace, there's something that happens in your heart because you have a relationship with Jesus. Maybe you're praying over your family. Maybe you've got a lot of responsibility right now. Maybe you have, you know, a fear about doing this or that or the other. But you want to maintain your peace. Well, how do you do that? You listen very keenly. Ephesians 6:15 talks about the sandals of peace. You have to listen every day now. So going forward this week, you want to have peace on a daily basis. A peace that doesn't just sustain you, but a peace that guides you. Because when it talks about this, it's talking about the ability to be mobile. That's what it's actually meaning. The Roman legions had a sandal that made them mobile, and that's the reference here. It's making mobile your life right now in the middle of a pandemic. Now, normally, you don't have to worry about being mobile, but now you do. And doing that through faith, peace can guide you. I'm going to give you one tiny example, and then we're going to talk about this for the rest of the week. A couple weeks ago, I was doing something when the pandemic was going on, and there was something that I wanted to do the following day. And at night, I was praying about it. And it's not like I heard a voice that was very, like, an audible voice. I mean, it can happen from God, but I didn't. I just had this very keen sense, be very careful tomorrow. Now, because of what I had to do and what I was going to do, I just did it a different way. But when tomorrow came, I saw something happen, and I knew why I felt what I felt. So God can grow at this time an awareness in you. What does that mean? It means that every day you probably want to pray about your day. Every day you want to seek God's guidance about tomorrow. Doesn't mean that you can't do the things that you used to do, but you know, it's not just about social distancing here, which you should be doing. It's also about praying, crying out to the Lord over each day, to know how God will glue your day together. Now, most days you might not hear that. I've only heard that one time over this whole time. But when he speaks to you, make sure you listen, because God will be faithful to you and he's faithful and he's for you. God is for you, remember that. Pray, grow in your attitude of peace and just listen to God. Thank you, God, that you spoke to me that day. One day out of the whole 3 weeks, but one day where God, thank you that you pointed me in the right direction. He can point you in that direction too. God bless you.